Hey YouTube,
I don't believe I've made a video of my 17 GS Adventure yet, F800. Yeah, I know I didn't, so here it is. It's got 2403 miles on it right now. I bought it in March because this one dude was like, man, it's getting warmer. I was like, no, it's not. He's like, yeah, it is. And I'm like, yeah, maybe it is. So it sat, in my garage for like a month and a half before it even got warm out. But, I've owned it since March. It's got 2403 miles on it. I gotta bring it to the dealership already. This is the fourth time it sputtered and stalled out on me. I'm like, what the hell? I thought this problem was resolved with, like, the 1150 GS. I guess not. Because I Google searched it, and people 09, 10, up to even these 17 are having fuel problems. I'm hoping it's bad gas for me. I read one article where the guy replaced his fuel pump, and he said it works great, but who knows. So my thing is, the first time it sputtered on me, that was bad gas. I know that for a fact. The second time it did it, I'm hoping it was bad gas. But after the second time it did it, I started putting the Lucas fuel stabilizer in my engine. In my gas tank, not my engine. So, and yeah, if you are thinking about getting one of these, this is the oil, it's $15.50. And it's $15 a quart, maybe $16 depending on the dealership you go to. I bought it at one dealership, it was like $15, and I bought it at the BMW dealership, it was $16. I've tried, maybe there's another oil you can use. I picked up this Mobil 1 $15.50, but then I Googled it, and it says not designed for wet clutches, which is what this bike has. I'm like, shoot. So, alright, so after the second time it sputtered, I would put that in the gas tank after every time I filled up. It did the third time. The third time was the worst, because I was stuck on the highway for about 20 minutes before it even turned back on. And the fourth time was this past Sunday here. It was running fine, and then it sputtered a little bit when I started to slow down to make a turn. I just rubbed the piss out of it, and it seemed to be fine after that. And then, a little after our journey, I came to a stop to turn to the other side of the street, and it just stalled. So, I had to push it to the other side of the street, and I was on a hill, so I was going down the hill this time. And I let the clutch out and nothing, and then I hit the ignition again, and then it turned on. So, that's why I'm bringing it to the gas station. That's why I'm bringing it to the dealership, because I'm sick of this crap. Is it bad gas the fourth time? I don't know. And I've been putting fuel stabilizer in it every time I fill up. Even if I put 2 gallons of gas in it, I'll put the fuel stabilizer in it. And apparently, I'm getting it from Good Gas. I get it from Holiday, and I get it from Super America. But more recently, I've been getting it from Super America because they're right down the street from me. But I don't know. I'm at a loss. I hope the dealership can fix it. Because I'm really hoping it's just bad gas or something along those lines. But if the dealership can't fix it, I'm just going to give it back and get whatever money I can for it, because I don't want to deal with this crap. I bought this BMW. One, I wanted one, you know. I didn't have the money for the GS1200. That's pretty big. And I've been watching some videos on YouTube, too. And the guy's like, oh, why do you need a bike this big, you know? Your 600s can do it, your 650s, 660s can do it. I'm like, yeah, you're kind of right. And he said some other stuff, I forget. But his name is, I can't remember. It's Adventure something, and he's over in, not Germany, he's over in one of those European countries. He's pretty good. But, I'll put the name in his description. But, yeah, I just don't want to deal with this. I mean, the bike is amazing. I love it. Compared to my KLR, I love this BMW. It's amazing. It rides so smooth. It shifts pretty good, besides going in the first gear. But I think that's with any kind of motorcycle. It's always hard to get in the first gear. But all I did was buy this light protector, the crash bars, and the skid plate, because it came with a plastic skid plate. This is all it came with. So that's not going to do you much when you're off-roading. Well, it's got a 6.1 gallon gas tank, and I love it. I'm averaging like 52 miles per gallon, which is sweet. Yeah, besides the bad gas, I don't have any complaints about it. Not that much. One thing I love, I tell you much, this bike, I didn't know it was going to be so quiet, but if you want a quiet bike, this is the bike. It might sound loud now, but I mean, it is quiet, dude. Like, all the way around, I love it.
You got your, temperature. I don't know what that is, I have yet to look it up. But, yeah. Your four-way flasher, that's pretty cool. Right there, you can shut the ABS off in the traction control. So you can normal, sport, comfort, and then right here is mode.
It has a Enduro Plus, but it's under the seat, and it comes with a little USB thing to plug in to put in Enduro Plus. You have the heat grip. That's pretty cool.
And you can flash the high beam. Got nice Brembo brakes.
I like how the gas tank's under the seat. I think it's pretty cool. Put your key in it. Oh, hold on. Yeah, it comes with this USB thing and now, you put it somewhere over here to put Enduro Plus mode on. But it comes with this little toolkit. Not much, really. I thought it would have had more, but... yeah, and you get your filter right there, and I'm not sure what the hell's under here. Oh, this is where the air filter is, my bad. And the spark plugs, too. But, the seat, I'd recommend getting another one. Because it does get... After about 2 hours... I find it gets pretty hard, just like the KLR, which I don't like that, but it is what it is. I'm 6 feet tall, and I can touch the bottom of the ground evenly. The seat height's like 35 point something inches. It's almost the same as the KLR, but yeah, a recommendation I would say is get a new seat, because after about 2 hours, it hurts. And that's not even off-roading, that's just like on the highway. I haven't brought this off-roading yet, because I... Still has the street tires, so I was thinking of doing some off-roading once these tires get worn out all the way. Yeah, I guess that's all I really have for this bike. The crash bars were like $370. The skid plate was like, I don't know, it was around $370. They're both from Toratech, and this light protector is from Toratech too. It was like $125 or $130. Alright, so yeah, like I said, I'm 6 feet tall, and the windscreen, it's fine. It goes right over my head. So I don't have any problems with that. So if you're 6 feet tall or shorter, you'll be fine, too. I don't have any luggage racks. So I had a soft bag for my KLR, so I just went to Giant Loop and bought another exhaust shield. So I can put my soft bags on it. And that's my soft bag, the Giant Loop Great Basin. It's like 62-liter bag. It's pretty nice. I guess I'll do another video. But, yeah, I got the Canon oil filters. I try and take care of my bikes. That's the number if you want a Canon oil filter for your BMW if you decide to buy one of these. Yeah, I have really nothing bad to say about the bike. It shifts smooth, it drives smooth, I like it a lot. Alright, so the brakes, sometimes they feel like they're good, they'll stop good, but other times it seems like it takes a bit longer to stop, like when you're coming off the highway. I'm not sure why. Maybe it's just me. This bike has a center stand, which I like. It's pretty sweet. I guess I'll show that. Ah, crap. Yeah. Just bear with me, YouTube. There's the bike up on the center stand. I've yet to ride two up on this. I've yet to ride two up on anything, really. I don't plan on it, but if I did, then I do. What else can I say about this bike? Not much, really. It only has 2,400 miles. Oh, yeah, this thing. I've yet to even mess around with that. That's for the dampening of the rear shock. I guess it would have cost too much money to just make it electric. What else? Yeah, that's all I really got, YouTube, so think of anything else, I'll put it in the description. Yeah, alright.